the seagull is holding my head without a phone. I said, seagulls, stop it, Barry.
We were working out.
For 15 minutes.
Pardon?
So we've been working out for 15 minutes, Marianne.
Yeah.
Yes, I'm sure, Ricky.
How do you know? Where's your evidence?
Getting a little slower.
Where's your evidence that I'm lying? You're just casting out lies without confirmation. Confirmation that confirmation is folly. You need three witnesses, says the Bible. It's only one.
Oh, boy.
You gotta read.
Nate.
Do you even science? Do you even science?
Still?
So we're gonna go, Dan.
Yeah, I'm gonna
go, boy. Dan, this is the routine you should do before you hit the gym or before you walk to lengthen your spine. Some mobility in those hips. You want to feel the restriction as you go down. Don't cheat with your posture. Make sure you feel it in the hips. There's three big ligaments there. Let's stretch upwards. Explode out with our breath. We go down slowly as we breathe in. Explode out. Go down with a squat. Find the floor. Slowly walk yourself out. Control. Touch your chest to the mat. Back up. Walk yourself. Back to your squat position. Up and touch. And down. Face is slippery. Up. Walk yourself slowly back into the squat. She loves it. PT in the morning. Good for you.
Did you say coffee in the morning?
I didn't have it yet.
Oh man, I had it.
I just had some.
Gonna have the death coffee.
Concentrated beef isolate.
What is that?
That red crap I'm drinking.
It's a real strong
beer. Yeah, sounds like it.
I can't get on.
I think one day I'm gonna have that world's strongest coffee before I teach class, then you're all...
Oh man, yeah, we're in trouble. I'm not even coming. Forewarn me.
The death wish coffee.
Yeah, death wish.
I know I'm not moving. It's too hard. I'm dying.
Alright. So now that we've warmed ourselves up, we're going to go into our roll positions. And I will do the most basic forms first. Most basic form is just laying there. Then I'll show you where to build up from there. You raise left arm, you look at it, and at the same time you raise the right leg. And you breathe out while you do that. So it's a inhale, I drop my head to the floor. The opposite side.
I love that music.
And down again and reverse, reverse. You're looking towards the arm, it's raised.
Can we keep our leg up in the air or not?
Opposite arm, opposite leg goes up. Keep the head moving, don't bash it off the floor, but rest it on the floor.
Hey, oh my word.
So the next position, it's a little less basic. Both arms, both legs in the air. This is our Superman pose. While we're here, we bend the head in flexion, touch the floor with our forehead.
And we raise up straight, look at the wall in front of us, or Nate's feet. And then you go down, keeping the arms raised, everything up. Look to your left. Again, this is not the most basic form, so it's a little hard. Down, don't forget to breathe while you're doing this. Look to your right. Breathe again. And there we go. So that repeats.
Marianne. She starts laughing, forget it. Look to I'm right. doomed. I can't down do it four. With she laughs. She cracks me up with that laugh.
Look. Alright, oh, so the next step up from there is you're looking the direction you want to roll, but rolling could be bad for you if your core isn't strong, because you're going to use momentum and potentially hurt yourself. So what you want to do is roll just to your side, like that. It actually takes some good control strength to stop there, and then you roll back onto your stomach. Look to your right, roll up.
You're doing a good job.
And down. Now, obviously the next step is you're going full roll onto your back. Resting your head on the floor, you must put the head on the floor and stop. Then return to your mat. And then roll the opposite direction. Head on the floor, core strong, legs stay in the air, and back to the mat. Now obviously someone's saying, I can't do that.
You can't go that fast.
I can't do that, like Debbie's saying. And that's because you stay in the most basic forms first until you are strong enough to roll.
Well, I did so the basic way.
She's over here using momentum trying to roll, so she's going to hurt herself trying to get up there and roll. Well, that's why
well,
I taught you.
What am I supposed to be doing? Just the looking?
The basic steps first. Got it? Aww. So then we're going to roll to our back and run through the basic steps there. So
then why are you doing that? We're trying to do what you
do. Why? I was talking and explaining why. All right. On our backs. Low back, flat to the floor, head pushed to the floor. You want to feel those neck flexors tightening, but you don't want to be tucking your chin all the way. You just want to be getting any curvature out of the neck. So the most basic form is everything is resting. If we can't do anything there, that's fine. Stay there. If you want to continue, you're going to raise your right arm to your left leg. If you can't touch it, that's fine. I touch my knee, that's what I do. Now, one thing I missed is in this position, you want to flex your toes towards you. That's called dorsiflexion.
Ow.
Where in the opposite form, you are pushing the toes away from you. That is plantar flexion.
Oh, I didn't realize that could hurt someone
to
do that.
Yes, so you're going to stretch those little hammy strings a little bit more in that dorsiflexion. This is a whole body workout, so even the ankle matters. The idea is we're working everything, so no matter what posture type you are, this will help you.
Okay,
the main goal of this is to lengthen your spine, so if you want to concentrate on such a thing, that would be
this one.
Good. I'm trying to think of a fancy word, but I went with the good.
skip the fancy, who's feeling fancy this
okay.
morning?
So, the next step up from the cross crawl is everything off the floor, arms, back flat, head flat. And legs up. And then what you do is you pick your head up, put it down, roll it to the left, roll it to the right. And then once you've expanded past that, you roll to your side like we did before. I'm catching a theme here. Then you roll to your back.
Good grief, you're going so fast you can't even.
And then you roll to the right. So we're just rolling to the side. Not a full roll. Just going back to the back again, rolling to the left. And then, most obviously, the next step is the full and complete roll, which you should only do if you're prepared for it. Looks like this. And I'm looking again. And you'll notice this one combines both elements, the back and the forward.
The two came to class for itself today.
The two positions that we just did before. Came to class for myself, I would be keeping quiet, enjoying the silence. So everyone practice.
You're amusing us today, that's for sure.
Everyone practice the first position, and I will tell you possibly where you should stay.
Which position?
What?
The stomach position. The Superman position. It's always your first position because when you're always going to get on the floor from the squat.
I'm pooped already. Those things kill me.
So try just the cross crawl. Debbie, you are not in the first position.
Well, what the? Well, you were going so stinking fast. Who knows what you're doing?
Well, two out of three got it.
So. Well.
The Bible almost clarifies that. It's a strong case.
Oh, my word.
You said cross crawl, right?
So you're raising your right arm.
I got tired just listening.
And you look towards your right arm. Perfect.
Great. How do
you? You exhale once you do that. And then as you inhale, you go back.
Whatever on earth you're breathing.
Get your forehead on the floor. Look, flex that. So you flex, you'll feel your spine lengthen. Yeah, so you get that head down there. You want me to wipe your mat so it's not dirty?
No.
Nate, you've never seen her do
that. Want to get that forehead to the floor?
Yeah.
There you go.
But I was supposed to look at my arm with my head on the floor.
No, that's just the middle position. That's your resting. You always return to the resting position.
Oh, okay.
And then you look to your left. You raise. Good. And then back to the resting position. And then look to your right. Okay.
Thank you.
Let's see yours, Marianne. Oh, that's solid. That's good. How the shoulders feel?
Which one is she doing?
Oh, cross on my right one.
We're not going to worry about Debbie. All right, try try holding everything in the air at once.
Please,
with that.
Stop it. He's so bad this morning.
Can you put your forehead down?
Everything, yeah, you want the arms and legs, and you raise your head, and then you go from flexion and extension, forehead to the floor, looking at the wall. And then, yes, you switch from left rotation to right rotation, but don't forget to do the middle as well.
I keep forgetting the middle.
These are all reflexes.
Well, when you do the middle, everything goes up, correct?
Everything should be up at all times. This is why this is the middle stage.
Oh, I didn't get to that one yet.
So Debbie's not at the middle stage. She's,
oh, that's really
nice. Marianne is barely at the middle stage. Well, this one is able to handle the middle stage, I feel. Let's see your side roll. Here, look towards the arm that's rolling. You just go to the side and go forward.
No,
not you, Marianne. You stay there. You reach your hands.
Marianne, not you.
You gotta work up to that one. Okay, she's not ready for you. So you're all pretty much in the same place. And that's good. That's fine. I'm not telling you you should roll yet. Because if you're gonna use momentum and try to roll, that's gonna hurt. This is to strengthen your core. So work up to being able to do those next two steps. It's the only reason I'm showing you them, so you can have a goal. Another good goal is flatten against the wall before and after this to see if you've made any changes. If you don't feel like getting up against the wall would be easier, rethink your approach. So usually I will spend approximately 5 minutes doing this. The squats. Walking back and forth is good for the rotator cuff, and then this lengthens your posture, and then you're ready for whatever exercise. Or if you're just going to walk, that's good, because if you're going out walking like this, it's not going to do you any good. So you're taking your bad posture out to walk with you. So if you do 5 minutes of this, if you're upright, you'll be more conscious of it, and you'll just be aware of it, and your body will want to do it, and then your walk will be much more beneficial for you. Your abs.
It's back to my legs, they're like wicked.
That's what it's supposed to do. Squeeze your abs and your glutes.
Let's pull my hair back.
Do some toe touches and then do the baby rock. Loosen those hips up.
I like the baby rock.
Make sure you feel the stretch. Don't be going for the motions. Maybe it's to further your reach. Expound on your restrictions. Don't be sticking with what you're good at. Get deeper. Point your toes out a little bit more.
Today.
toes out to the side, didn't he?
Out to the side. Oh, my knee.
Feel it now?
Probably from scrubbing floors this morning. My knees are really sore.
Maybe scrub it. Good quad stretch here.
Just do that.
And lengthen the spine. Bring your head back. One arm behind your head. Press your head back against it. The stretch in your shoulder.
Just one arm?
Just one.
You push with your head and push back.
I'm pulling the other arm across.
Wow, the shoulder. Wow.
Don't forget to breathe. Other arm.
Wow. How could something so little hurt so much?
Another 10 seconds on the tightest arm. Head motion while you're here.
I think we're going to have to get after Jeanette.
I didn't answer the phone, but I know she went off the schedule, so.
On your stomachs.
I think we're the old diehards.
Forehead on the floor.
Or serious.
So first, you're going to raise, tighten your stomach, raise your right leg, toe pointed away, left arm, look towards the left arm, and breathe. As you breathe out, drop both to the floor, head back to the center, and do the right. And then keep going. Left.
You're supposed to be looking at?
Mm-hmm. Look toward the arm.
Mm-hmm.
And I want you to raise your right arm and your right leg down. Sure. Look towards your right arm.
Mm-hmm.
And you raise both arms. Mm-hmm. And you're going to pretend to roll, but don't roll. Just lift your left hip up a little bit, tuck your core, then drop back down to the other side.
I can't raise both arms.
All that restriction in the thoracic area.
makes it hard.
I can't if I put my forehead down.
Oh, where's my stomach after a while?
So weird.
I want to build up to keeping everything in the air. You hurt your stomach, you're laying on your stomach.
Stomach.
You shouldn't be doing that.
I know it.
You want to be lengthening your spine.
That is hard.
If your abs aren't tight, then you will be laying on your stomach.
If I pick my head up, I can't raise both hands. Is that weird?
Mm-hmm.
Can't. I can do, if I keep my forehead down, I can do it. But if I try to pick my head up, I can't. Oh, there's a little tiny bit.
So we'll roll to our backs. We'll get back on the mat. Let's rest for a second. Get the lower back a break now by working most of the abdominals, flatten your low back.
That's fine with me. Ah! That dumb thing hurts.
Core tight, head pressed against the floor. Right arm to left leg, keep the toe pointed to your nose. Breathe out as you reach. Breathe from your diaphragm. Breathe from the belly. I want to hear that breathing.
Mary and I both are laughing.
What you did there, Debbie, wasn't a good breath.
No, it wasn't. It didn't feel good either.
You were holding at the breath. You went, it's breathing out the whole way. Slow and controlled breath.
Oh, why do you have to do the breathing? What's that?
It's the most important part.
Is that why?
It has to do with pumping the cerebral spinal fluid up and down your spine. Also has to do a bit with anaerobic and aerobic exercise.
Ow, great leg. Man, he's alive.
So now we're going to try to hold both arms, both legs in the air. And then you're going to pretend to roll left. Don't lift your head off, though.
Okay.
And then right. And then left. And then right. Left. Don't let your head pull back.
Wait, how are you doing?
And right. And left. Oh. And right. Left. And right. Keep that head flat to the floor. And right. And left. And right. And left. And right.
Left.
And left. And right. Relax for a second. Lengthen your spine. Flat to the floor. Toes pointed at you. We're going to roll to our stomachs.
Yeah, right.
Pour it on the floor. Abs tight. Spine lengthened. Left arm, right leg. Toes are pointing away from you now. Into your want, you can do both at the same time. Holding up and just interchange your head. So this is the next step up. So everything's off the floor. The only thing that's moving now is your head. Or you can just do the slimmer variation to work your way up to this. Still breathing. I'll even look in the middle ones too.
They're hard, mate.
It's not that it's so hard, it's that our posture is so bad.
Agreed. How about you, Marianne? Are you dying yet?
And then we're going to do the roll. So the harder variation of the roll is everything in the air, same thing. And you're looking, raising one hip and dropping it down. Looking, raising the opposite hip, dropping it down. Looking, raising the opposite hip, drop it down. Looking, drop it down. Keep that core tight.
I keep forgetting to do opposite.
Opposites.
I know.
We're on the same or opposite? For that one.
For that one, it's the same side.
Okay.
So it's not the cross crawl. For the new roll, when you're going to be rolling, you should have everything in the air, right? You're not pushing off. But you're actually throwing the opposite side over to give you momentum to roll.
Yeah.
So if you want, you can get on your side and down to work up to.
Shoot. I'm pooped.
And that actually can help train your core a little bit better.
Good grief, mate.
Because a lot of people, they'll ask you, you're rocking like this, and you're twisting yourself, and you might be throwing something out. So we're doing baby steps to work ourselves up to doing a good roll, so we don't hurt ourselves. All right, so careful. Roll your back. Nice and slow. If you can't roll like that, you always get your elbows underneath you. Slowly go. And just remember which side you go to, because then you want to go to the opposite side the next time you roll, just to even yourself out. Some people think they're constantly going. They're switching, but they're not. I'll see a lot of this. Like, oh, I went left, and now I'm going to go right. And no, you're not. You're actually going left again. You're always turning in the same direction. So you want to counteract that. So if you turn left and you want to go right, you go back the way you came. Then switch it up the next time. Now where are we? We're on our backs again. Okay.
Oh, where were we supposed to be?
On our backs.
Okay.
I got confused. Ideas don't That's rush okay. it. Nice Agreed. And slow. Get your shoulders pinched underneath you. Make sure your shoulders aren't up, because when you raise them, the shoulders actually get pushed down, which is good. Get your spine lengthened. You always want to get your body lengthened as much as you can before you start this exercise, because you don't want to be doing it while you're rounded. Because that's the major problem with America. You take our rounded, crappy posture into the gym and expect to get good results.
This is the first time where my head is actually comfortable on the floor.
Really? Yes!
Yeah. No, seriously.
That's good.
Before it was like, oh, so painful. I'd always had to put something behind my head.
It's like putting a rolling pin on your spine. Except we're the rolling pin.
Nice.
Left leg up. Reached. Just breathe out. The opposite hand.
Toes toward us, right?
Toes are towards you now. You want to feel the stretch in the back of your legs. Mm-hmm. When you put the leg down, make sure your back stays flat.
Mine won't go flat.
You're pushing. It's like God told the guy to push the stone. You tell him to roll the stone. As long as you're pushing your abs down, trying to get there.
Okay. Rib wanting to pop out.
Because believe it or not, your low back is actually not supposed to be that flat. We're just doing that to reverse back curvature. We're forcing it in the opposite direction.
So someone who it can easily get their back flat to the ground, don't need to concentrate there as much because they're already flat. They want to spend more time on their stomach. Alright, so everything in the air, hollow body hold, toes pointed towards you. So now you can hold everything. This is the advanced step. Lift the hip up.
Oh, that's hard.
Hip up.
Oh man, that's hard.
Hip up. So you're stopping in between because we're not rocking. We're not using momentum. We're stopping because it's all core. We don't want a limp spine. We want a strong, lengthened spine.
Oh my goodness.
And the advanced is you're going to roll to the side.
You get this. Oh, Marianne, I'm dying over back. There.
Yeah, I had to stop.
Try not to touch the floor. And back.
I whipped out.
You whipped out?
I did.
So back.
It's painful on my low back.
I hope I'm doing it right. Oh man, I cannot go to the left. I don't know what my problem is. Go to the left side is very hard for me.
Then do more on the left. Never force it.
Well, I force it.
Don't use momentum. Just do what you can.
You can do that.
If you can only get there, that's fine. If you can only get here, that's fine. You work up to being able to do this. And then keep your core there.
What are you doing?
Well, it all hurts.
Actually touching
it hurts down my bottom.
Oh. No,
it's the slower the better. We're not using momentum, we're using the core.
My core died.
You're supposed to be up, right?
Yes, ma'am.
My core died.
Trying to keep your arms level with your ears.
I cannot keep my back down.
That's because we have that hump strong.
The hump! But it drives me crazy because it hurts actually to do this stuff with that thing.
Bubbling. On your left side.
I need to put something on my stomach to push it back.
I feel like I have your head.
Rib trying to come out. Shoot.
Inner thigh. Make sure your hips are wide.
On that one.
Core tight. Running the knee along the shin. Go until you feel the burn. Try not to roll too much. The bent knee should not be moving too much. It will move, but you do your best not to let it move. And then try to get the leg all the way to the floor too. Don't keep it all the way bent. You want to get that full range of motion of the hip. Force it down to the floor. Down to the floor, I even push off the floor a little bit. Push against the knee. Push off the floor. Push against the knee. Push off the floor. When you push off the floor, you open the hip a little bit. Go up, push up the knee. Push off the floor. And you just go until you cannot go anymore. Try to keep your spine lengthened.
Ow. Oh, my hip burns.
That's when you want it. Feel a little burn, and then we'll switch to the other side.
Mm-hmm.
Careful with your rolling. Steady as she rolls.
Steady as she rolls.
Lengthen spine, core tight. Press off the floor with your straight leg. And really glide it along the shin. Press off your knee. Down, press off the floor, Push up against the knee.
Oh, whoa. My hips popping out every time I do.
Tighten your stomach some more.
Now I need.
Popping's not always a bad thing.
That's what I said.
Popping's not always a bad thing.
No.
Means there's instability.
Lots of it.
I always try to tighten stuff to prevent the popping. Keep pressing off the floor with the legs down. Up against the knee. Against the floor. Against the knee. I'll sometimes cut my head too, so I can push back with my head, push back and up with my head. Both hands behind your head. Both hands behind your head.
Oh, both hands?
Push up and back with your head. And then keep doing the leg thing. Your spine is lengthened while you're doing this.
What am I supposed to do with my other hand?
Both hands are behind your head.
Oh, like that?
Supporting it, and you're pressing up with your head and back with your head. Go until you feel the burn. All right, good. Let's do a couple bridges now. Shoulders pinched first. Stance wide as you can get it.
Palms up, right?
Palms up. Press off with your heels to stretch your shoulders. If you want, you can clasp your hands and work your shoulders deeper.
That feels good.
So good.
Having my hands behind like that, then they would stay there.
Drive with your heels. Force your shoulders down. Turn to your right. Your head. Keep your butt up. Turn to your left. Slowly. Don't yank anything. Find the way which feels tighter. Then stay there.
Oh.
Wow.
For your neck, do you mean, Nate? Or...
Yes. They both might be tight.
Yeah.
Drop down, bring your feet together. We're gonna raise again. Grab the floor with your hands, raise your left leg, point it straight. Keep your knees together. Squeeze your knees together.
Wow.
Put your toe towards you and push away. Once you have more balance, you can turn your palms up.
How do you get your knees together? Oh, you only bring it this high?
Keep your knees together so you don't raise it too high.
Okay.
Put it down. Drop your butt. Raise up. Other leg. Knees together. Squeeze into the knees together.
That leg is a lot harder.
So forward and back. We're gonna do some circles.
It's hard to stay on my right hip with that one.
Most of our core is a little unbalanced. Abs are stronger on one side than the other.
Wow.
This will for this is kind of like being on the one side of the ball, the yoga ball like we used to do. Same idea.
Can you do it on that side?
You want to focus on the side that's tighter. This side's not as bad for me.
Yeah, the left is like it's strong. I can do it.
Working the ankle kind of just distracts you. Keeps your mind off the pain. So when we get off the floor, we want to first roll to our stomachs. Think about which way you want to roll, and then roll the opposite.
Roll the opposite.
Yep, my instinct was to go to the left, so I went to the right. I do that with a lot of things in life. If I want to get up on my left leg, I'll stop and switch, go to the right. Sometimes if I get up quickly without thinking about it, I'll go down and do it the right way. When we get up, we tuck elbows underneath us, core tight as we raise. We don't want to be arching, we want to raise here. Then we want to get back, raise one arm, and see, I went to the left instinctively, so I'm dropping down, going for the right, then raising both. And I'm planking, stretching, walking back. Into the squat, easing into it, raising slowly. We should feel tall. Tall and amazing. Now try to touch your toes like you did before. You may notice the difference. Oh, not much easier to get to the ground. Careful raising back up. Now when you go to your left and your right, you might have noticed some tightness differential. Just check and compare. Really easy going left. Really easy going right. That means I did it good. If it feels really tight one way, I'd go back and do some more, trying to even yourself out again. Test it. Questions on those? So you're working up to it without actually rolling. So we didn't actually do the baby roll today. It was all basic, but still really hard, right?
Yeah.
It's like some people like, oh, I bruised my hips when I did the baby roll. That's because you're not doing it right. So yeah, flatten up against the wall, see how it feels. Let's see how we're looking today.
We should have done this before.
Well, we already know what you look like before.
Yeah.
That's so much better.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, look at you. You're almost there.
She's crushing me.
I'm what?
She's always crooked.
I'm always crooked. I have curves.
Leans toward you. Look at that. Never noticed that. Oh, man.
That's actually much better than she normally is.
Really?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Normally, I'm.
I've never noticed that about her.
Just remember, Debbie, before you pick the speck out of your brother's eye, first remove
the plank from your own.
You know.
Which is important. I remind myself of that a lot. You know, I'm like, I look at everyone's posture. I'm like, oh, why is everyone so bad? Why is everyone so bad? For like my first 2 years in practice. And I'm like, I'm so bad. I'm the worst.
She said I'm not perfect. Don't point that stupid thing at me. Get that thing.
Definitely look good.
Straight up. Core tight. Head to the wall. Head to the wall.
Get that thing out of here. I hate that thing. Is it straight up? Seriously.
Oh,
I know my back is
too much fun.
This is bad.
Yeah, definitely. Because for you, it's almost easy to get that there. It's here. That's
it's
the problem.
It's back further than it used to be, though.
Your shoulders are pushed forward a little bit. Try to get your. See what happens when you get your arms at the wall. And raise your elbows a little higher.
That's
tough. And then I think that's better for you now to work that. So you just squeeze your abs flat in the wall for 5 seconds, and then relax. Squeeze and hold. I find that's better to do throughout the day than trying to hold it there all the day. So when I'm in the car, I'll squeeze and I'll push for like one breath and relax. Yeah. Squeeze and push for one breath. And actually you'll focus a lot better that way too. Because you'll be rigid and try to hold that. Right. And you might be good for a minute, but it's gonna fall apart.
Turn that thing.
It's just gonna fall apart.
That thing's gonna fall apart. You're not gonna have a phone.
It's already got cracks.
It's gonna have more.